today, I thought I'd make a video rounding up everything we know from Gamescom and the little bit of time around it about Battlefield Hardline, and conveniently put it all in one video for you. There's been a lot of information that's come out over the last few days, both from people that have played the game there and then come back and given their opinion. There's been various sort of news articles that have been created. There was even like Ask Me Anything with the lead developer on the CTE program. So there's so much different information that's coming out about Battlefield right now that I thought I'd just stick it all in this video and make it nice and easy for you to know exactly what's going on at the moment. To start things off, Battlefield Hardline's second beta and its release date. According to an interview with a member of the Simthic forums, a Visceral representative confirmed that the second beta for Battlefield Hardline will be coming in January 2015, 1 month before the game launches in February. The gentleman went on a little bit further and confirmed that three platforms will be used for the next beta, at least at this stage, which is the Xbox One, PS4, and the PC. Now, last generation consoles, the game is actually being developed by a standalone developer. It's not being made by Visceral directly. Yes, they made all the assets and everything that's going to be included in the game, but it's not actually going to be coded by Visceral and put onto a disc and distributed in that fashion. It's going to be very similar to how Titanfall worked for last generation Xbox. That was made by Bluepoint Games, and they did an absolutely amazing job at getting the best out of the game possible because they had their own dedicated development team. Now, having mentioned Titanfall, this game, Battlefield Hardline, is coming out in the same release window that Titanfall came out in 2014, back in February. So, looks as if this year, the shooter that's coming out for EA is going to be Battlefield Hardline in that slot. Doesn't look as if we're getting anything else. Next, we're going to have a chat about some of the things that have changed since the last beta, and ultimately some mechanics and weapon balance and things like that. First of all, we have the Survivalist gadget, which was probably at the centre of most controversy in the last Hardline beta. This gave the Operator class the ability to simply revive themselves after they got shot. A lot of people thought it was overpowered because you just simply get regen back to 100% health, as if you'd never even been shot by the other player. Now though, Visceral have implemented a fix. Basically, you can only use the Survivalist perk if you're killed by an explosive. So that's like an RPG or a grenade or something like that. And the idea being that it could have been a random death. You could have got hit by an RPG from across the map. It could have been a 5 meter away shot RPG, or it could have been a lucky grenade throw, something like that. And it just gives you the ability to get back up again because the death may not have been warranted. I still don't think it's a very good implementation, because basically you're still giving yourself the ability to sort of be reborn back into the game exactly where you died. So if the guy did get a good RPG shot on you, or he did throw the grenade where he meant to throw it, then I still don't think it's fair that you get back up off the ground. But definitely, it's better implemented this way than it was in the last beta. Also, the RPG gadget has actually been removed from the mechanic class in Battlefield Hardline. So the engineer class that we know and love from Battlefield 4 in Hardline won't actually have access to the RPG at all. Now, that might sound like a strange decision, and when I first heard about it, I thought it was a bit too, but the reasoning behind it is this. The RPG does not fit into the cops and robbers fantasy. Visceral got a lot of feedback from the beta saying that you don't tend to see many cops running around with a massive great RPG on their shoulder, and you sure as hell don't see robbers getting their hands on them very often. So then if you look at it from that way, I can understand why they made the change. And within that change, Visceral have also been given the opportunity to make the RPG a little bit more powerful, because there will only be a select few on the map. It means that those explosions aren't going to be as regular. We already know that Hardline's going to be very much infantry focused. So it means with the RPG that they can create some really amazing sort of explosive moments within the gameplay. Because they're going to be so few and far between, they can make them much more powerful and much more dramatic, which I think sounds like a really cool idea. Following on from that, you might think, well, what does the mechanic get in replacement of the RPG? Because you essentially take away a very powerful tool from what was a very balanced class, I think. Well, they've decided to replace it with the M320 grenade launcher or the sabotage kit. Now, the sabotage kit is sort of like an item and a bomb that you can strap to anything that's interactive in the game. So like a door or a vehicle or something that you can do something to. and when an enemy goes near it, it sort of surprises them by blowing it up or making an explosion. And of course, they have the M320, which is just a grenade launcher. So they've kind of replaced the RPG with something that's just as effective, but may not directly impact gameplay so much as an RPG would if you were holding it right in front of you. I think it's quite a good change, and a lot of people have said they don't really like the change, but I guess we'll just have to see in the beta that's coming in January. For the next part, I just want to say a massive thank you to Danny on PC for posting all of this on Reddit. He managed to get a huge amount of information from the game and actually managed to remember it all, which I think was very good of him. And he's put it all on Reddit for us to see, but I'm going to highlight some of the main points that he found from the Gamescom build of the game. First of all, the weapons that he managed to get his hands on or play with or see in the trailer. The first one is the Chris Vector, or the K10 in game, which will have 1,200 rounds per minute in it, which is frankly amazing. According to Thad, the lead gameplay designer, this thing empties its mag in around 2.5 seconds, which is just ridiculous. It means that you're either going to miss all your shots or they're all going to land on target and you're going to have to reload every single time you've shot somebody. But that still sounds really cool, a new weapon to the game. We're going to see the M249 return from Battlefield 4. I guess this will be a robber's weapon. It could be a cop's weapon as well. I'm not really too sure, to be honest. We also have the 1911 pistol, which is always a good thing to see. We've got the R0933, which is a variant of the M4 carbine with a collapsible stock and a shorter barrel on the front of it. So it's a little bit more portable than an M4 might actually be. That sounds quite cool. The Scout Elite and a DMR has also been spotted by Danny as well. So looks as if we're going to see a nice variation of weapons. And of course, we haven't seen them all yet, so there will be more to see. Apparently, there are going to be a lot of melee weapons in the game, including a golf stick, like a big hammer and a crowbar, along with the police baton that we've already seen, and the baseball bat as well. So it looks like we're going to have a lot of variation there, which is good to see. One thing I really liked is the fact that you can now shoot and jump, which is something you can't do in Battlefield 4, and you can do in Battlefield 3. It sounds really simple, but if you try it in Battlefield 4, if you jump, you cannot fire your weapon until you've landed back on the ground and your player has reset back into the standing position. And ultimately, that takes around a second and a half's worth of time, by which time you've already been shot by the enemy. And in Battlefield 3, that didn't happen. You could shoot while you jumped, and it meant you could have some sort of jumpy around really fast gunfights. A lot of people didn't like that, but I think it's really going to work for the infantry-focused shooter that Hardline is supposed to be. There is a mention in Danny's post that there will be a game mode and a map that will feature jets. Now, not really sure how that fits in again with the cops and robbers fantasy, but we'll have to wait and see. But it does sound quite cool. There's still going to be some element of the Battlefield series in there that we all know and love. And finally, one of the maps called Gator Hunt, there is actually going to be a real-life alligator that roams around the map. Yep. That sounds epic. Oh, and one more thing that I didn't mention. You're going to be able to master weapons in this game, just like you could in any other Battlefield game, but it comes with a little bit of a catch, and I think this is quite cool. Once you've mastered a weapon, you can port it across to another class. So if you wanted the M16A3 in the professional class instead of a sniper, as long as you master the weapon, you can do that. At the moment, I don't know whether it's limited to just one weapon in the game, i.e. you get one choice of weapon that you want to put into another class, or whether it's sort of like account specific or something like that, but I feel if you could port too many weapons, then it would just sort of ruin the class balance a little bit. Ultimately, I think that sounds really cool because if you work hard at a weapon to make sure you're the master of it, then you should be able to use it however you like. But anyway, that's about it. I think that was all I was supposed to tell you about Battlefield Hardline. You're pretty much up to date right now. If you do want to know about anything else or you have any questions for the developers, I will be putting together another email in about a week's time and sending that across to Steve Papoutsis, the general manager at Visceral Games. I'm probably going to get the chance to talk to Thad and Ian Millam as well, who are both the lead gameplay designer and the creative director on Battlefield Hardline. So if you do have any questions, leave them down below and I'll send them across in that email. But that's about it, you're up to date. Hit the like button if you enjoyed the video, and as I said, leave a comment down below, they're always appreciated. But until next time, my name is Westy, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.